Alrighty. Hey, Chris. This is Max. Max, we're gonna trim his face. He has overactive tear ducts. He produces more saline than normal. So I just shave his face and it takes care of that problem. So, being a good boy. You wanna flip the ears back and you wanna start the corner of the eye to the ear. You wanna start at the ear and we're gonna go backwards. I've got a 10 on my Andis trimmer here. In the eye, you want to scoop from the inside out and go towards the tip of the nose. You want to pull the skin to go. You want to do it pretty fast. Pull the lip back. You want to do it pretty quickly. Pull the mouth shut. And it's all done backwards. I have to hold his lip back to get the little spots. Now when it gets to closer to the neck, I go down. He's got a lot of gunk on his face, so it's a little harder there. So I want to go the back of the blade at the eye and move it away. And you want to keep it moving, otherwise it'll burn them. So do the same over here, Max, sorry. And Max, of course, hates it. And the eyes in between, I use just a little bit of the blade. Up. Clean all that gunk like that out of there. Pull the skin. Especially around the lip really fast. And then the neck. Yeah, you're a good boy. The neck, you want to make a V. In a V shape. So you want to do it backwards under his chin for the entire chin, but not the neck. In the neck, you want to make a V. That's the proper way to do a neck on a dog. It's in a V. Now, because he has tear stains, I'm going to use a surgical blade, a 40. And that'll get really close to his skin. You have no reason to use a 40 blade. And these will really burn the skin. But it takes a lot of the staining off for Max. I can get in there the same way and clean that up. So for the face, you want to use a 10. And the face should only take you a couple minutes. You're looking better, Max. The rest of that will come off when I bathe him. That's how I shave it. It's pretty easy. Say bye, Chris. Bye, Chris.